Call Roger.
0151 709 9333.
BBC Radio Merseyside.
I'm Tony from Kirkby on the line now. Hello, Tony.
Good afternoon, Roger.
Good afternoon to you.
Yeah, I'm just following with regard to them. I don't know whether many people know this about Ramsey, the CEO of Knowsley, actually stepping down at the end of the month. And really, it's baffling me what I'm reading and what I'm hearing about lawyers who are actually looking at what redundancy should be getting. I'm not going to go into that. The two things that are bothering me is their actual record while she's been CEO, and how Knowsley Council is spinning this now to say that she's actually leaving to save money. I'm just wondering what you think about what's going on.
She's certainly going to save the money if she leaves, so she clearly is saving the money.
Right, but, I mean, her record is appalling when you look at it.
I think many people would disagree with that, but you're entitled to your own.
Well, let me just get... No, this is not my opinion. I'm actually going to give you some facts.
It is an opinion. Appalling.
Yeah, well, what I'm saying to you is that I'll give you the facts behind the opinion.
Right.
What we're talking about is that she stepped down as a chief executive to take voluntary redundancy. But the authority had a report from Ofsted which branded its services for children at risk and care leavers inadequate. Its Safeguard and Children Board was rated the same with significant, according to them, significant weaknesses in management. She's also been a part of other inexperienced staff carrying out visits to children, significant weaknesses in management, infrequent poor supervision, and a forthcoming report about adult social care, which is likely to give cause for concern. Now, if you add on to this, the education attainment in Knowsley, which is, as far as I know, still nailed to the bottom of the league of the country, the health and well-being of the people of Knowsley, the lowest life expectancy, the highest cancer and respiratory disease, add on to that the Destination Kirkby fiasco, I think we can honestly say that you're not short of a disaster here time as CEO of Knowsley Council.
Well, you've included in there some things which aren't directly her responsibility. I mean, you take the schools. That problem in schools has been going as long as I know. Have I been here? So 30 years. I can remember some major changes that were made pre her being chief executive.
Okay, but surely then her role, her remit was to come in and sort that out. She obviously hasn't. So we can't say, well, she had no responsibility for that. She's the CEO, and if the CEO's the boss, as far as I know, is that right?
Well, yes, but there are many other layers below any CEO.
Of course, but she's the CEO, and that's the top layer. They're the boss who, you know, everyone else works underneath them.
You could argue that the person responsible is the leader of the council rather than the CEO. The leader of the council sets the strategy.
Let's come to that in a minute, if you don't mind, right? So what I was going to say to her, I'm not here to attack or, you know, really Sheena Ramsey. I don't know Sheena Ramsey that well. I've met her a couple of times. She seemed, you know, a nice person, whatever, but she was obviously incompetent. And
I'm not just saying she's incompetent. The council's working. It happens. There are areas where it has been criticised.
Yeah, but the incompetence is what's being done in the time of her tenure, where she's been paid like £2 million+ over the 9 years, and things have got, obviously, some people might say the worse or better. I'm just stating the facts of what she's been involved in. These are things that we have to live with every day of our lives as community members, and that's what I'm saying. Now, what's actually irking me is what I've just said to you, is that her lawyers are now in the process, we're getting told, of working out the terms of their redundancy,
which could be
a six-figure payoff.
So it's reported.
This is what it's reported, obviously, allegedly. So what, you know, from my point of view, maybe she should be paying us for what's happened.
Well, of course it won't, but
what I'm saying is maybe we should be looking at things like that rather than her lawyers. I mean, why don't they negotiate with the people, you know, residents of Knowsley, and see how much they give her? That's what it is.
They might do quite a lot, because there are some areas which should be very successful. Any chief executive, Mr Cameron is chief executive of the country, there are things that are going to go wrong and not go well. That happens with every single chief executive in this country.
Yeah, but there's a saying, isn't it, the book stops here, and obviously, this brings me on to my second point, because as I say, I don't want to go on and sort of badmouth the woman.
All right, it's two and a half minutes, go on, yeah.
Okay, so The other point is that, like you've just said, the leaders of the council and the council, councillors, the 63 Labour councillors, must have seen all this going on and yet supported her and backed her and kept her in post while all this was going on. So
there are people below her in post as well, the director of education, the director of services, like you just said, Ronnie Rounds in charge,
and he said, we'd like to thank her for the contribution. Well, that's astounding. Yeah, but it's astounding that he's supporting someone who's done so badly in a job.
But you're picking out one or two particular things where you argue she's done badly.
Roger, you're not going to give me time to speak out there.
I agree that two of them, they are independent reports which have said these areas have been bad, education and children and youth services.
I know I haven't got time to be picking out everything, and as I say, I'm not here to castigate the woman. I'm just saying that the way it's gone, I need to bring this point up, that she's gone to save money. How cheeky is that? That they're telling us now that the CEO of Knowsley Council has actually took voluntary, so St. Sheena has took voluntary redundancy to help save money for Knowsley Council. It's a load of nonsense, Roger, and you know it is. It's a disgrace.
That's your view on it, but the fact of the matter is she will save money in the way the last chief secretary who left here saved us money because the next one came in at a lower
weapon. We believe there should be a full inquiry into her activities, and we need answers. Why did it get hold?
Say that again, sorry. Are you there still? Yeah. Say that again, sorry. Oh, he's got his disappeared. I'm sorry. Apologies for that. I certainly didn't mean to do that. I pressed the button wrongly, which Tony will now accuse me of being censoring him, but it certainly wasn't. I think he got his point well across about what he feels about the situation in Knowsley. Others may want to comment. Of course you can. It's 01517099333 if you so wish.